Sunday, February 20th, 2011. After enduring several days of heavy rain, I'm out on Cajon Pass for another day of train watching. I'm set up at the old Route 66 alignment near Mormon Rocks to catch my first train of the day, the westbound BNSF QCHI LAC from Chicago, as it makes its way down the pass headed for Los Angeles. Thanks to a recent snowfall, the snow covering the hills that surround my position is going to make for some really good shots. Acquired trackage rights across the Santa Fe over Cajon Pass in 1905, and in 1966, the Southern Pacific built the Palmdale Cutoff as part of their line between Mojave and West Colton, California. Now the only railroads that use Cajon Pass are BNSF and Union Pacific, as the Santa Fe became part of the BNSF after merging with Burlington Northern in 1995. And in 1996, Union Pacific bought out the Southern Pacific altogether. Later, I'm set up just above the S-curve on the number 2 track below Mormon Rocks. These two crosses were set up as a memorial to Santa Fe Railroad employees Kevin Williams and Gil Ortiz. The two men were killed in 1996 after their train lost control while descending the pass, becoming a runaway, and derailed at this very spot. Off in the distance, I hear an eastbound BNSF train coming up the pass near Sullivan's Curve.
Alright.
Just a minute later, I get out of the car just in time to catch the eastbound BNSF SLACHOU as it passes my location. This train is headed for Houston, Texas. Just a short while later, I arrive at Summit just in time to catch the westbound BNSF MBARWAT, a manifest from Barstow to Watson, California, just south of Los Angeles. Upon reaching Los Angeles, the train will make its way down the Alameda Corridor to Watson Yard, where it will terminate its run. occur, the eastbound BNSF QLACCHI comes into view. This is a hot intermodal train out of Hobie Guard headed for Chicago.
I'm good.
This westbound UP double stack train as it passes through DeVore on the Palmdale cutoff headed for Los Angeles.
Thank you.
following close behind is the UPMOAWC out of Oakland, California, rolling out its final miles to West Colton.
Yeah, they had a big accident up there one time.
Yeah, that was, I think that was around there. Actually, the spot where that, if you mean the one that happened back in 96, that was actually a little further up. But I know which one you're, I know which one you're talking about, because I saw the memorial there for the two guys that were killed. And just like I thought, he's got an SD90 on him.
I'm not familiar with him enough to know which guy is which.
Westbound BNSF SHOULAC passes by from Houston, headed for San Bernardino, and then Los Angeles.
electricity is still and power provided funds because they don't have like the proper equipment for that. So they have their like the two trips that 3751 ran to Tornado last year and the two weeks before that they had to be going to search the cars.
Let's walk through the private cars. Boy, what a gas that is. You know, it's got rear view mirrors on it. You know, you sit in one of the seats and there's a mirror on the side so you can look forward.
I've never seen a railroad car that had that.
Shortly afterwards, the eastbound UPM LAMP heads through from Los Angeles, headed for North Platte, Nebraska. Up making this the last train I catch for the day before calling it quits and heading for home. On the BNSF Cajon subdivision at milepost 71.0, this is the UP844 at DeVore, California, out.
Stuck up in the past because one of the leaders was working, so he had to check it.